Welcome, I'm Anna Galletly, and we're going to continue talking about Unit 1. We're going to be looking at the epithelial tissues now, and we're going to look at how those are basically structured in this video lecture. All right, so we have four basic tissue types in the body, all right? So this is the term you want to think about. When you see this, you want to think about four types: epithelium, connective, muscular, and nervous. I'm going to be focusing on epithelium right now, and then in Unit 2, we're going to do connective tissue, and then we'll do muscular and the nervous tissue more when we get to those. So with the epithelium, where you're going to be seeing that is lining and covering organs, tubes. It's often used in tissues that do secretion, or glandular tissue that does secretion. All right? So let's go on and let's look at that a little more closely. All right, so the major characteristics of epithelium. First of all, they are closely packed and they are mostly uniform, which means the same size and shape, okay? So if they were loosely packed, it would be something like this. And you see I'm doing all kinds of different shapes. That's not what we have. We tend to have things that are all the same shape, same size, and then they are closely packed together. Oops, that's kind of a bad rectangle. Okay, now, really, really important, apical layer and basal layer. So I'm gonna have a membrane down here. And this is actually going to be connective tissue, okay? So that's always there, always, always, always. We're gonna call this the basement membrane. And then I'm going to put my epithelial tissues on it, okay? The part that's against the basement membrane is called basal. The part up here that's free is called the apical. So this is the free edge, all right? So that's a really important characteristic. Epithelial tissues always have a free edge, and they are always attached to connective tissue on the other side, okay? Epithelial tissues are also avascular, meaning they have no blood vessels, but they have a really easy time regenerating, okay? So they can go through mitosis and create copies of themselves and replace themselves pretty easily. All right, next slide. All right, here we're gonna look at the three shapes and that we're dealing with. Okay, well, first of all, let's look at the classes. I have simple versus stratified. Simple means one layer. Stratified means two plus layers. So I can see I've got one, two, three, four, and then I can see a hint of a fifth layer here. Here, I can only see one layer, okay? Then you've got this whole thing called pseudo-stratified. Pseudo, that prefix means false. So falsely stratified, which means it looks stratified, but isn't. Okay? What that means is I've got a cell here, and I've got a cell here, but I've also got a cell here. Now, it might look like this doesn't come down to the basement membrane, but every single cell touches the basement membrane, okay? So it is technically one layer of cells, just like a simple epithelium is, okay? Now we've got shape, all right? Squamous is flat and thin, okay? That's all that means. Cuboidal, you've got a cube, okay? And then columnar is your rectangle or column. Now notice what's happening with the nucleus. The nucleus in squamous stays in the center, okay? And this cell is so thin that where the nucleus is, it kind of does a little bubbly thing, okay? In cuboidal, the nucleus is round and it stays in the center no matter what, pretty much. Columnar, the nucleus is more oval in shape and it tends to float towards the basement. Not always, that's a general tendency, okay? Next slide. All right, this slide, I am just showing you the boundary between simples and stratifieds. Okay, so epithelial types that have one row and epithelial types that have two plus rows. Now my line didn't do the right thing when I copied it over to this program. So that's basically the line right there. So pseudostratified, even though it looks stratified, is technically one layer. So you've got simple squamous, simple cuboidal, simple columnar. And it's important to always put the simple in front, because down here I've got stratified squamous, stratified cuboidal, stratified columnar. So if I'm on a quiz and I ask you what type of epithelium this is and you say cuboidal, you haven't answered the question, because I don't know that you know the difference between simple cuboidal and stratified cuboidal. So you need to always put the entire name. Okay? Let's go into the next slide. All right, as part of your lab exercises, I'm asking you to do concept mapping. And concept mapping is a really useful tool for taking words and creating a visual image of what they mean, okay? And I want you to learn how to do this. It's a little tough at first when you're starting AMP, but it's gonna make such a difference as you go on throughout AMP 1 and AMP 2 if you learn how to do this, okay? So we're gonna start with the different types of tissues, all right? So I've got four basic tissue types. I am looking at a slide and I want to know what it is, all right? So I'm gonna create a concept map of questions so that it's really easy for me to go through looking at a picture and figuring out what type of epithelium it is. So my first question is there a free edge? Okay, so I've got yes and I've got no. Okay, if I say yes, I know I'm dealing with a type of epithelium. If no, then I've got cartilage, bone, blood, or connective tissue proper. Okay, now we're doing the epithelium unit, so I'm just going to focus on this side. My next question is going to be rows. Okay, is it one row or is it two plus rows of cells? All right, if it's one row, I know I'm dealing with simple epithelium. If it's two, I know, I'm gonna bring it over here, that I'm dealing with stratified, okay? So with my simples, I'm like this. So now, so this is basically the number of rows. Now I'm gonna be dealing with the shapes of the cells, okay? Is it flat and thin? If yes, it's squamous, okay? Is it square? All right, then it's cuboidal. All right, now, when I'm writing this, remember, I don't wanna ever write squamous on a test question. I want to write simple squamous and simple cuboidal, okay? All right, is it a rectangle? All right, if yes, then I'm dealing with simple columnar. Okay, now, whoops, is it squished? All right, a nice technical term. Basically, do the nuclei look like they're all over the place, but it's still thin? So nuclei all over, but tissue is still thin. If yes, then I'm dealing with pseudo stratified. Okay, now with my stratified epithelium, so I'm dealing with two plus rows of cells. All right, now that I know that I'm dealing with a stratified, I am going to want to then figure out shape. So now we're looking at shape. Okay, with stratified, basically the apical layer is where you get the name. The basal layer is where it's going to go through mitosis, and those all tend to be cuboidal or columnar in shape. So we are looking at apical row shape. So is it flat? All right, if yes, then it's, I'm going to abbreviate this, stratified squamous. Is it cube? Then I'm dealing with stratified cuboidal. All right. Is it a rectangle? Then I'm dealing with stratified columnar. All right. And then we've got another one that I haven't really talked about. Okay. And that is bubble shape. When not stretched. We have a special type of stratified tissue that when it stretches, it becomes really thin, but when it's not stretched, it's bubble shaped, and this is called transitional. Okay? So I've given you an example of how I would do the concept map, and honestly, I redo this every term for every class, and each time I write it out, it's a little bit different on how I structure it. So yours doesn't have to look exactly like mine. What you need is something that helps you visually organize information. So practice this on your own. So that is the last slide for this video lecture. And then I'm gonna go on in the next video and I'm gonna showcase the simple epitheliums and what they look like on photomicrographs.